Another disturbance was reported at the abandoned slaughterhouse outside of Hills Prairie. Deputies responded to a caller reporting loud noises from the dilapidated facility after midnight. Police investigated the site and found evidence of trespassing and minor equipment theft, but suspect it is merely the work of local vandals. The search continues in Puerto County for a missing University of Texas.
Ah!
brutal attack on three female college students in Pflugerville, Texas last year is back in the public spotlight. Pflugerville citizens are in an uproar demanding answers from Texas state officials on why no arrests have been made in the case. Reports say an unidentified man entered the home and officially strangling one female to death before attempting to stab both roommates.
Whisper words, you come to me, the song I sing. Nowhere to go. One is one. I'll never say never to always. I'll never say always to none. To seem is to dream a dream of. 'Cause one is one.
Search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search nearby will unearth the lead. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding the
Thank you.
Jared Gaines wasn't sure what he was expecting when he discovered a burnt-out truck on his back 40 this morning. Gaines was patrolling the perimeter of his lab just after sunrise when he saw the truck in the distance. It was apparent that the truck was damaged from a distance, but closer inspection led Gaines to find the charred remains of a currently unidentified man in the driver's seat.
That's what I get for taking it easy on them.
Get loose. I can't fix this by myself, old man.
Thank you.
go, old man.
It's all right. Big boy's gonna be wearing your face soon enough.
After I'm done with you, that is. Come on back now. Got something I want to show you. The bad man. And you're gonna meet him real soon. Did those kids find us? I should have been more careful. Your little friend put up a better fight than this. Come on! Make it interesting, will ya? tastes best when it's fresh, don't it?
I thought you knew how to run this household. This is a mess!
Oh.
where your friend died? I can show you. Your head straight. Come on now. They always try to hide. It's always the same game.
Thank you.
series of home invasions throughout Bell County have turned into a search for a known fugitive. Omar Pauly, native of Holland, Texas, was arrested in 1967 for aggravated assault and larceny and was sentenced to 5 years in prison. After his release, Omar Pauly was implicated in a string of incidents outside McLennan County, where he was arrested.
Better go check on Grandpa.
Never see this. It always works. Somebody around here has to catch him. Drop me this little trick.
Fresh as it gets.
Get now, Grandpa. Get your fill.
Someone help!
murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers and three other young women along the route. Billy
Grandpa's taking a liking to you. So for his sake, use that head of yours and think. They gotta be close by.
These others around here ain't so understanding.
I can't help you.
Drink for all this craziness going on. Now, let's just get this over with.
Thank you.
Grandma ain't gonna tolerate this mess much longer. You better straighten up your act and find these dang kids!
Much interested in chasing around much longer, so stop your running. Better fix this mess or there won't be a home to come back to!
Thank you.
Here you go, Grandpa. Here you go.
Well, looks as if somebody...
Thank you.
What should have been a night of memories and celebration turned into a scene one witness described as hell on earth. Teenagers at Dutton High School were celebrating an otherwise uneventful senior dance when two local men, identified as 43-year-old Puckett Wafer and his 24-year-old son Bradley, entered the gymnasium with a variety of bladed weapons and began attacking those inside. Six students, all members of the football team, The man believed to be responsible for multiple stranglings in East Texas is finally in custody tonight. Authorities followed a tip that led them to a deserted motel outside Bryan, where they caught the man in the act of subduing 36-year-old Kelsey Keough. The man, whose name is being withheld, claims he and Kelsey were hunted in an agreed-upon way, and that he had no connection.
Mm-hmm.